Now, let's set up my flexible budget equation. And my flexible budget equation is fixed plus variable times x. That is my flexible budget equation, fixed plus variable times x. That's the flexible budget equation. Now, when we do variance analysis, we're going to use four different numbers. As I work across, we're going to be using four different things that we're looking at, because we've got to compare four numbers to come up with three variances. So we're going to start over here with actual. And the reason I like to start with actual is because actual is always given, so we can start with actual cost. Now, the actual cost, we're going to have our fixed, and we're going to have our variable. So we're going to have our actual, which will be our fixed, and our variable. Then we're going to have our flexible budget equation. Now, the flexible budget, this will be flexible budget equation at, since it's close to actual, it'll be actual. This will be our flexible budget equation at standard. And then this will be standard at standard, which is basically what got applied into production. Remember in another section we talked about raw materials, work in process, direct materials, direct labor, overhead was what? Applied. That's going to be this number. That's what got applied. What was that? Remember, it was basically our standard at standard. That's what got applied into production. That's going to be our applied, based on our predetermined overhead rates. This is going to be actual at actual, flexible budget at actual, flexible budget at standard, and this is what got applied into production. The difference between this and this is actual and applied. That's going to be our net overhead variance. But we're also going to take these and break them down a little bit more. Now, before I go on, let me just show you how to get the 1-2-3 variance approach, because that's what we're looking at. There's four different variances. You could have the 4-3-2-1. All right, so we've got actual cost, boom, to flexible budget at actual. We have flexible budget at actual, boom, to flexible budget at standard, and flexible budget at standard to what got applied. 1-2-3-4 differences gives you 1-2-3. That's why 4 plus 3 is what? 7, 7 spending efficiency volume. This is going to be spending. This is going to be efficiency. This is going to be volume. Spending could be both fixed and variable. Efficiency is electricity. That's all variable. Volume is production capacity, production volume. Things got unapplied. Because what happened here is as we're doing our production, what happened is some of your fixed overhead didn't get applied. Therefore, the volume variance is all fixed. So notice how four differences, 4 plus 3 is 7, SEV, spending efficiency volume, boom. Spending is both. That's how you get your 1-2-3-4 variance. Then, if we take it and go from this stays the same, it's still called your volume variance. This goes from here to here, this is called your budget variance. Budget is called controllable. Volume is called non-controllable. Now you have the two variance approach. Here's the three variance approach. And if you take this and break it out between fixed and variable, then it's 1-2-3-4 variance approach. So there's the 4. If you just have spending efficiency volume, that's the 3. If you go, volume is still part of this. This is budget, which is from actual to flexible budget at standard. And finally, if you go from here all the way to here, that's called your net overhead variance. So here's your 1, 2, 3, and then 4 variance approach. So there's 4 different ways. The net is 1. This would be 2. This would be 3. Breaking that out is 4. And you'll see a picture similar to that in your notes about page 5 or 6 or 7. You'll see that big box there. Actual overhead, flexible budget standard, and applied. That's how we get the differences. Okay? So that's again where you'll see those differences and how they are all interrelated.